The final of the Prada Cup gets underway this weekend to decide who will face Team New Zealand in the America's Cup showdown. Michael O'Keefe has all the action from the viaduct.
Official press duties are just wrapping up here. 2 days out from the start of the Challenger Final Series between Ineos Team UK and Lunarossa Prada Pirelli. Now, they've both made changes to their boats. However, Lunarossa skipper Max Sirena has detailed the changes they've made, but Sabine Ainsley, the skipper of Ineos Team UK, is keeping his cards close to his chest, not detailing exactly the modifications that they've made. Now, there are some changes to the race rules for the upcoming 13 race series. Teams are given one card to delay the race by 15 minutes to fix technical difficulties, and the wind limit is going to stay at 21 knots instead of rising to 23 knots as previously planned, something that Sabine Ainsley wasn't all too happy with.
That's what all of us have been designing our boats towards and training towards. So to change that at the last minute is not something we would have done. But again, it's not our decision, and we're not going to sit here and moan about it. It is what it is.
Now, racing kicks off on Saturday, where there are two races in a best of 13 race series. So essentially, it's first to seven. The first team that does that earns the right to take on Team New Zealand for the America's Cup.
Ineos Team UK skipper Sabine Ainsley says his team accepts the decision to maintain wind limits as they are for the remainder of the Prada and America's Cup regattas. The upper limit was set to increase to 23 knots for the Prada Cup final, which begins this weekend between Ineos and Italy's Lunarossa. But Team New Zealand and Lunarossa have decided to stick with the 21 knots used through the Challenger Series and beyond.
There are clearly safety elements here at play, and we were happy that it was the Challenger record and the defender's decision. And we told them our viewpoint, but we also said we will support your decision. So that's where we're at.
They've courted.
Anna will join us shortly. The best of the best are about to battle it out to see who will win the Prada Cup for the right to race against Team New Zealand for the America's Cup. With all eyes on the wind and the hype levels high, who is the favourite to win all this? Joining us now from the Viaduct is America's Cup veteran, Ken Reid. Ken, g'day. Good morning. Love to have you back. Welcome to the program.
Yeah, good morning, everybody. Nice to be here.
Who's your money on? Who's going to win this thing, do you reckon?
All right, you're going to think this is a cop-out because I know how these things work, but I think this is so close to call. I think anybody who says that they know who's going to win this is absolutely lying. This is two boats who we don't even know what boats are going to show up. These boats are going faster every single day. What kind of bits and pieces have they put on these things to go faster? And they're really aggressive teams, really well-sailed teams right now. I don't see a whole lot of weaknesses. So I think this one's just too close to call, and we're all hoping for a really long series. I think that's what we as sports people are hoping for.
When you say long series, for the ignorant and the naive, and which there are many of us when it comes to sailing, what does a long series look like? How many races could that be, and what does it look like?
13. Yeah, so it's best out of 13, so it's whoever wins seven first. So this is a long one. It's only two races a day, so this could go on for, you know, a couple weeks.
That is exciting.
There's a bunch of gap days. Yeah, a bunch of gap days in between. So, you know, this will be a little different from those other series that we talked about before that seemed like they were over so quickly. This one, I wouldn't be surprised to see this one go the distance, quite frankly.
I just I wonder how good will they be at the end of this? So the winner takes on, of course, Team New Zealand. How much of an advantage is it to be doing all this racing and for Team New Zealand to be, well, racing themselves and watching on? How much, you know, they go in so match fit into the final series of America's Cup. How much of an advantage is it?
Well, match fit, I think that's a great way of putting it. There's nothing like being match fit. You can be on simulators, you can practice. I mean, I know they go sail against their own tender. They have a rubber boat out there that they're jockeying for position with. There's nothing like being match fit. Now, at the same time, New Zealand has more time to put these bits and pieces on the boat to actually do kind of speed development. But I'll tell you from experience, you get in the starting box and the bullets start flying for real, you know, it's a different game. And match fit is exactly the right way to put it. The challengers will be ahead in that respect.
But just in this Prada Cup, you could speak about match fitness because you've had one syndicate who's been in the workshop and the other one out there on the water knocking out the American challenge. So one crew clearly more match fit than the others.
Well, but remember, their rhetoric also kind of has to meet their own situation, right? So it's very easy for Jimmy Spithill to go in the press conference and say, we always wanted to race because racing was the way we were going to see ourselves getting better. And then Ben Ainslie saying, oh, we always wanted to be in the shop because we see where we can make more improvements that way. So never bet against people's self-interest. The rhetoric is fitting their situations. Who knows what they think behind closed doors, quite frankly.
Ken, I have been a terrible Kiwi and I haven't actually made my way down there yet. Can you give us a flavour of what it's like down at the dock, what it's like out on the water, what fans can expect?
Yeah, well, let's hope that you bring some nice weather if you do come down here, first of all. And if that's the case, I have to say that I'm incredibly proud of Kiwis in general. You know, the COVID card that's been dealt has certainly not brought the tourism that people had hoped. But at the same time, I think Kiwis have come from far and wide. It's been very apparent to me. The viaduct down here is just very cool, very fun, very social. It's like a big block party during the race days. And then you have all the compounds, you have all the teams kind of mucking about around here. And then out on the water, I mean, sometimes there's not hundreds, but there's thousands of boats out on the water watching the racing. So you combine all that kind of excitement with the great television that has been produced for this event, and you have a real sport event that I think sailors and Kiwis should all be very proud of.
He's an ambassador for New Zealand. Good stuff. America's Cup, a veteran legend, actually, Ken Reid. We appreciate your time on the program. We'll catch up with you throughout the coming weeks.
We are actually very lucky. Part of the reason we haven't gone down to the viaduct yet is we can actually watch it from our house, which is very cool, just the location of it. And